What's up, family? It is Kaden with Urban Finance. Today we are going to be talking about the TI video where he tells people not to buy Cartier and Louis V. And if you're new to this channel, I talk about everything related to financial literacy, investing, and urban finance. And if I'm being honest, urban finance is literally anything I feel like talking about that week. If you haven't already, please smash the like button so YouTube shares this video with others, subscribe to the page, and hit the bell to be notified of when I post something new. All right, let's jump in. So let's watch the video together.
No, dude, that's not how we can't liberate our people that way.
In the dark?
You dig what I'm saying? Nah, man, can't operate back. Hey, listen, man. So we were just in the studio having a discussion, man, you know, and I just feel the need. I feel the need to share it. All y'all getting all this money from the government, man. All that PPP, SBA, all that shit. Listen, man. Ain't no more mint coats in the store. And it's summertime. Ain't that some shit? Ain't no more Cartiers. It ain't no more Louis Vuitton. No more Louis. Ain't no more. Go get you some property, please. Please, y'all go buy some property. Okay? Okay.
Get your LLC.
Listen. What you say?
LLC, goddamn it.
Man, that could be a bit complex and advanced. You know, it's too much paperwork and procedure. It could be a patch of dirt, bro. Sure. Go to your hood and find it. Ain't got to have no house on it or nothing. Just buy it. Buy it and hold it. You dig what I'm saying? Now that's it. Now I told you, you can't say you didn't know. Now y'all go ahead, enjoy yourself.
I can't be sure of this, but I want to say when he was referring to the PPP loans, while some people did get PPP loans, he may have been talking about stimulus check, but we know that the government is also investigating fraudulent PPP loans. So maybe he do know people that apply for PPP loans that didn't use it, let's say, to pay their employees. So let's assume that he means the stimulus checks that a lot of Americans have gotten. I actually really like what he's saying here, and for a few reasons. First, I like the fact that he's telling people to buy assets. And so I'm a nobody on YouTube, so if I tell you to buy some assets, you may be like, you don't know what you're talking about, Kaden. But T.I. is somebody you may have looked up to, somebody that you like as a rapper, somebody you might like have his lifestyle. I know he's been doing a lot of stuff that shows that he's kind of woke, as we say, not to pay him woke in quotations, just the terminology woke. You know, I'm not someone that kind of likes to put anyone in a box by calling them this, because there are some people that consider themselves woke that I think that are harmful in general. And then there are people that are woke that are doing really good work. So whatever, that's a sidebar right here. But the fact that he's telling people to buy assets by buying property, I think that's a very strong move. And especially, and not this is not directed at him because we all grow and evolve, but especially since rappers have been the class of people in the black communities that have promoted these luxury brands like the Louis V, like the Cartier, like the Pradas back in the day, like the Gucci bags, like the Red Bottoms. And now to have a rapper like T.I. and many other rappers, to be honest, because if you've read 50 Cent's book, Hustle Harder, Hustle Smarter, I think that's the title of it, he talks about the difference in his ideology now of when he first became a millionaire through rap, how he wanted the big fancy house, but now he knows that it's more important to build his wealth. And this is the same type of thing that T.I. is talking about, is that it's so much more important to build wealth than to chase after the fancy cars, fancy clothes type of things. And I really do think that this message coming from people like T.I. will change our society and change what people think is cool. Cool will go from owning a BMW to owning your own house, or like he put it, just owning a piece of land, even if it's nothing on it. Because truthfully, in a lot of communities where land may still technically be cheap, if you buy that land and hold it, let's say for 5 years, 10 years, you can probably actually make a good profit off of it. Just that long-term investment mindset is so beneficial for communities of color, especially black communities. And so I am loving what T.I. is saying in this video. And I see some people even on the website that I originally found out about this video on critiquing him and talking about, oh, you're 10 years late talking about this stuff. And I fully disagree with that perspective. Yes, I do think that rappers in general promoted a very destructive culture to black communities. And I'm gonna make that general statement. There are a few rappers that did not promote a destructive narrative within the black communities. But generally speaking, I will be honest, and you know, we can have this debate in the comment section. The culture rappers have promoted within the black community have been very destructive, from the violence that they have promoted and from the consumerism that they have promoted. We can have that debate in the comment section anytime. And I'm speaking as someone who favored rapper, especially growing up, was 50 Cent and loved gangster music. And so I'm not speaking as someone that was not a consumer of that culture. I understood why people were attracted to that. I was attracted to that as a high schooler. But I also recognize the fact that it was dangerous to the black community in America, and honestly, it was dangerous to the black community in the diaspora, because many people throughout the entire world looked up to black rappers, and a lot of people still do. And so while some people, like some of the comments that I'll probably just put up on the screen for you to see, one person says, wonder if he said this on his album, "You're decades late, dummy. This bleep is your version of a bleep light bulb moment." And so, you know, a lot of colorful language. So a lot of people recognize in some degree that he's saying something good, but are critiquing him because he didn't say it early enough. And I'm not gonna focus on critiquing him. I would like more rappers to come out and be advocates for creating wealth in the community. And so that can be buying real estate, that could be invested in stock market, especially more sound investments like the S&P 500 instead of chasing gains, which I may be guilty of sometimes as well, in single stocks. Overall, I really like what T.I. was saying here. I mean, it was an impromptu video to his Instagram followers, but I appreciate the effort. I look forward to other rappers doing the same, even if it's an impromptu message. Like I said, 50 Cent also kind of talk about this mentality in his book, Hustle Harder, Hustle Smarter. And I have a video about that that I'm gonna link to the end of the video. So make sure you check out that video as well. But it's the same type of ideology that growing from 50 Cent to Curtis Jackson. And I love to see rappers evolve in this manner. That same thing goes for someone like Jay-Z. And so as these rappers evolve, I do think they are gonna have a significant impact on their communities as a result of this. RIP to Nipsey Hussle. And so let me know what you think in the comment section below. Let's continue the conversation. Do you think rappers are going to have a significant impact over the next 5 years when it comes to economic development, especially in the black community? Because that's what we're talking about. All right, that's all I'm going to say for this video. If you haven't already, please smash the like button, subscribe to the page, and hit the bell to be notified of when I post something new. And like I always say, even in the midst of these crazy times, make sure you're living your best life.